Let's work through a word problem that involves three-dimensional vectors. So here are the directions. A plane is flying horizontally due east at 350 miles per hour when it experiences a horizontal wind blowing northeast at 60 miles per hour. There's also a downdraft blowing vertically downward at 20 miles per hour. What is the resulting speed and direction of the plane's movement? Okay, so we're dealing in three dimensions here because originally this plane is flying horizontally, and when they say horizontally, they mean just in usually the XY plane, right, just in two dimensions. But then you'll see later that it experiences a downdraft. Okay, so that's going to cause vertical movement, so we introduce a third dimension. So this is why we need three-dimensional vectors to solve this problem. So let's start just by kind of sketching these different vectors involved here on our XYZ coordinate plane. Okay, so first of all, we're told a plane is flying horizontally due east at 350 miles per hour. Okay, so let's establish our directions here. So generally, the positive y-axis is considered to be north, and then the positive x-axis is considered to be east. Okay, so this plane is flying due east, so solely in the east direction, at 350 miles per hour. So 350 is going to be the magnitude of that vector. So here I've drawn a vector to represent that movement, and I'm going to label that v sub p to represent the velocity of the plane just on its own when there's no wind. And let's also take a minute to actually go ahead and write that vector component-wise. Okay, so there's only one component here, right? We're traveling solely in the positive x direction, and our magnitude is 350. So our vector is just going to look like this. Or another way I could write it is as 350i. Okay, so what's next? So the plane is flying horizontally due east when it experiences a horizontal wind blowing northeast at 60 miles per hour. Okay, so horizontal once again tells us that we're still in this XY plane, and northeast tells us direction of the vector. Now, without further specification, we'll just assume that northeast means at a 45 degree angle, or exactly between north and east. So let me sketch that into our picture. So this shows us a general direction that we're going, a northeast here, and I'm going to label this vector W to stand for wind. Now this vector is going to take a little bit more work to write its components because it's not solely in the x direction or solely in the y direction, right? It's some amount in the x, some amount in the y, and we need to find out what those components are. So let me draw kind of a close-up of this W vector and the geometry that we're looking at here. Okay, so here's our W vector, and then I've just simplified here with the X and the Y axes. Now, we just said a second ago that northeast, okay, so once again, Y is north and X is east. Northeast meant a 45 degree angle. Now, knowing that, we can resolve this vector into its components. So the magnitude here of W is 60. Okay, and we learned before how to do this, so if we want to know the x component, okay, which I might label w sub x, well, that's going to be the magnitude 60 times the cosine of 45, okay, because x is on the adjacent side of this angle, this 45 degree angle. Now the y component, we'll do a similar thing, it's going to be the magnitude 60 times the sine of 45. Okay. So now we know the x and y components of our vector. So I can now write vector W as an x component of 60 cosine 45, a y component of 60 sine 45, and then a z component of 0 since we're still in the horizontal plane. Or once again, I could write that in terms of I and j if I want. It'd be 60 cosine 45i plus 60 sine 45. 45J. Okay. So there's one more component, one more vector that's going to affect our movement here. We're told that there's also a downdraft blowing vertically downward at 20 miles per hour. Okay, so what's that going to look like on our picture? So vertically downward is going to mean in the negative z direction, like I've drawn in blue here. And I'm going to label this vector d for downdraft. Now this one, the components are going to be easy to write because it's just in a single direction. So then vector d has no x or y component, so 0, 0. And then the magnitude of this vector is 20, but it's in the negative z direction, so I'm going to write that negative 20. If I wanted to write that in terms of my coordinate unit vectors, it'd be negative 20 k. All right, so what's next? Our ultimate goal is to find the resulting vector of the plane's movement. So to do that, we're going to simply add together these three vectors. Okay, so then I'm going to call the resultant movement just vector v, and it's going to be the sum of vector p plus vector v sub p plus vector w plus vector d. Okay, so we're going to be adding just by components here. These three vectors. Okay, and if I do that, for my resulting x component, I'm going to get 350 plus 60 cosine 45. For my y component, 60 sine 45. And for my z component, negative 20. And now, just so we have a better sense of what's going on here, let me go ahead and get some approximations for these each of these values. Okay, so 350 plus 60 cosine 45 is about 392.4, and this would be all in miles per hour. And then 60 sine 45 is about 42.4, and then we have our negative 20. Okay, so we want to know the resulting speed and direction. So this is our vector, right? This is vector v. But we kind of want to separate this into its magnitude and its direction. So let's start by finding the magnitude. That's probably the easier thing to think about. So the magnitude here is going to be this simply the square root of the sum of the squares of each of these components. So the square root of 392.4 squared plus 42.4 squared plus negative 20 squared. And if you work that out, you should get approximately 395.2, and the units here are miles per hour. Okay. But now we need to think about the direction of this movement. Now, in a future section, we'll learn methods of describing the direction of this resulting vector more exactly. For now, we'll just describe it kind of intuitively. So the resulting movement of the plane is a speed of 395.2 miles per hour. And let's think about the direction. So as far as how it's moving in the horizontal plane, it's just going to be slightly north of east, right? Because if we think of this vector v, right, the plane is originally moving due east, and then this wind blows northeast, but the magnitude of this wind is so small in comparison to the magnitude of the plane's velocity that it's not going to push it off course that much. So we'll say slightly north of east. And then same with this downward draft. The magnitude of this is small compared with the velocity of the plane, so it's going to only affect its movement slightly. And we'll say, and slightly downward.